So today, we will learn the set plays, all right? Set plays. So in basketball and other sports, like football, you see, I don't know if you know those sports, but there's always the coaches having X and O's diagrams, right? They put out a play, and this person goes there, this person goes there, and they write it out, and they try to implement that play, right? In on whatever sport they're doing, right? Football is the greatest example of that, okay? In tennis, we don't normally do that, but I would suggest you do that, but not, you know, do it in a way that is overly complicated, okay? So we're gonna do some set plays, which basically means it's a scripted play, right? So for instance, there is one play that we'll do where the server will serve to the tee of the box. So it's all gonna be on the deuce side. All right, you're gonna serve it right around this corner, all right, so that the returner can hit a backhand, all right, and the terminator, which is the net player over there, will move to poach, okay, will move to poach, and the server will switch sides, all right, and try to intercept a ball that may go there, all right, and then you just play it out, okay, and then we'll work on another play as well. What's the good part of these set plays, you think? You kind of predetermine a play. What's the good part about it? What is it that makes, you know, what happens there? What happens in those when you try to do a set play and try to execute it?
Higher probability of success.
Yes, all right. So we want to get our percentages up. All right, as opposed to just kind of serving it, hoping it goes in and hoping the other person misses and hoping we win the match, right? What's that?
Don't mess with my game.
That's your game? Just hoping everything goes your way. Some players do that and they're successful, you know, they're amazing. But, it's good to implement some set plays so that our percentages get, you know, higher, there's higher probability, and most importantly, I think it makes us be more proactive. All right, this is a sport where you need to be proactive, not reactive, and not hope, you know, everything is going our way. All right, we need to be proactive and impose our game onto that other opponent, that other team, so that we can win. We can try to win the match. All right. So that's what set plays does, but we don't want to get it too overcomplicated, all right? We could have all these diagrams, this guy goes here, you know, and, you know, all of a sudden we have this huge math equation on the chalkboard and it becomes too much. So we want to be simplified on that. So there's three things that a set play needs to have, all right? So one, the server, all right? It could be the returner too, but let's just, you know, the example of the server doing the set play. The server needs to go to a spot on the court, all right? A spot on the box, all right? There needs to be an intention to go somewhere, all right? So on this case, my intention as the server is to go to the tee, all right? The second thing is you gotta know where to move, all right? So the server, we'll need to move to the left, and the poacher needs to poach that ball, right? Okay, and the third thing is, the target. So you move, right? You wanna know where you hit the ball, right? When the ball is going at you, okay? So in that play, I know where my first target is, the serve. I know where I'm moving, and I know where I'm targeting, okay? So that's it. Everything else that happens after that and the point, just play out the point, all right? You don't need to plan anything else after that. Oh, what if it goes here? Okay, that's it, all right? That's when overcomplication happens and we don't want that, okay? So, but that's the three things you just need to know. And I'll let you create some plays yourself, all right? A little bit at the end of this class if you'd like to, okay?
Hey guys, thanks for watching.
follow me on Twitter and Instagram at TopSpinAdrian, and check out some of my other videos. See you next time.